Hello and welcome. I want to show you a project that we're going to be doing live on my scrapbook group called, my Facebook group called Scrapbookers of Country Craft Creations. And sorry, my camera is moving. The folio we're going to be making this Friday night. And that is, let me get the calendar here, Friday, June 29th. So I will be posting the measurements. If you are in Scrapbookers of Country Craft Creations on Facebook, the measurements will be posted there. If you are not, then you are welcome to join us. Just come on over to Facebook, send a friend request, and not a friend request, but a member request. And we do live tutorials every Friday night. So this is the folio that I will be doing live with the Imagine paper. And I left this because I want to write on the back. And to open this, we have a magnetic closure that it slides out. So that on, whoops, the closure too, you can, when if you're going to give it as a gift or just keep it, you can still put your photos there because I used a large magnet so it will hold it shut. And when we first got in the Imagine paper, I have to tell you the truth, I didn't think I was going to like it. These are really hard to get out, as you know. But I just started looking at it and I absolutely love it. I'm not sure something fell. So this little tag is in there, and what I do with these little tags, because I've been starting to put pictures, I'll write on this, and then I will tuck it like in the picture, or tuck it back in the envelope, or, you know, sometimes you just want stuff there because they're cute, and these little envelopes are cute, from Graphic 45, not always the easiest thing. So let's go ahead and open our folio. Now when you open the folio, these two will mirror each other. So let me show you the side first. And I used the chipboards on the inside here. This will fold down. And this is the back of the ephemera card. So to let you know, for the tutorial, I did use a collection pack, the sticker sheet, and ephemera cards and chipboards. And the sticker sheet comes in your collection pack. The only thing, if you want, you can do extra is your ephemera cards. But you don't have to. Excuse me, you don't have to have them. And then I use craft cardstock on the back because the paper is so, it is so pretty. Look at those butterflies. But it's very colorful. It's already busy. And putting the craft there, I think, really helped break that up. So we have the same thing over here. I just chose different cards. So I used all of the fronts for that one. You know, this is steampunky, but it is also summer. I just love it. So again, this is one of the cut-aparts, and these are the ephemera cards. And I did not back those or anything so they could be written on. And then, of course, they're just beautiful. The colors, I just love the colors. It's not really a pink. It's kind of a peachy. Well, I think the dog's upstairs making a lot of noise. This was from one of the cut-aparts. It's a little bit different of cut-apart, but it's really cool. They're different shaped. Then we have from the tags and pockets and tags and pockets, and then one of the ephemera cards just to put inside there. Now these will open. They're on a hinge, and they are nice big pockets for a photo mat. And also a picture can go here, a picture if you want can go back here, definitely. And then we have the same over here. Backed it with the craft card stock, our own artisan card stock. And again, a picture, and then did a little fussy cutting. This is the 4x6 cut aparts. Oh, and I also want to tell you, so there's plenty of room in between this hinge that you can also embellish. Boy, there's a lot of noise going up. I hope Wilbur's not on the counter. So these are the back of the 4x6 cards for journaling. And then there is a big pocket here too. The only thing is we are out of, I wanted to use the Graphic 45 tags and use my dye, but they're out of the ivory, and so I right now just left the tags out, but when they come in I will get those. So we have two, and this is also from the tags and pocket collections that you can get, and then just journaling spots. So you can just journal on there. And of course, nothing wants to go back in the way it's supposed to. So we'll fix that later. And then you have another one on this side, and also the tags and pockets on this one. A little extra spot for some journaling. Then we have our middle section. And like I said, we're going to do this live in our group Friday night. And so all the measurements will be posted there. And this will open, so I use the craft cardstock again, just so this will be four pictures. And then this is a smaller, but enough room for 3x5 photos, or you can cut down your 4x6s however you want. Then we have, this is one of my new, I'm making it. I'm not gonna say it's mine, I don't know, it may have been made before, but it's a lay flat pocket. And it does have a place for a tag. Actually, there's two pockets back there, but I'm only utilizing one. And it lays nice and flat, so there's no bulky scoring or hinges. And these are from the Cut-Apart sheet, so you can see how they're different the way they're laid out. They're really cute. Sticker. And then we have photo mats to the left. You can see it, the paper's quite busy. And again, I just use the tags and pockets. And these are stickers. And I just backed them on some cardstock. Because they really are nice. So after you can put down your picture and then decide if you want to put another embellishment there. Or dear friend. So they are good to use and back. So you can use them for other things. And again, tags and pockets and stickers. And inside of each pocket, we have two nice long photo mats, and then you do still have room for pictures. So join us live Friday night over on Scrapbookers of Country Craft Creations, where we're going to make this live. Just to have to lay down. This one goes here. And then when you put it together, you just kind of move those guys over. And then in goes the closure, and it will snap shut. And there is our folio. So I can't wait to make this live with you guys Friday night, the 29th. And I'll see you over on Scrapbookers of Country Craft Creations. Bye-bye, everybody.